This is what the big, large companies are doing to grow their audience, to expand their reach. And the thing is, you have this at your disposal. Facebook ads can be something that can adjust to your budget. You don't need to be rich to start running Facebook ads for your business. So our topic for today is Facebook ads. And I have this crazy love-hate relationship with Facebook ads. I actually used to hate. And when I say hate, it's not like the kind of like annoyance that you get when like there's a fly buzzing by and you're just like annoyed by it. No, it's the hatred that you feel towards your worst enemy. That's how I would describe my complete hatred for Facebook ads. And I did a complete, is it 360 or 180? Complete 180 when it comes to Facebook ads, because I realized how much power it actually brought, or how much business and how many amazing things Facebook ads did for us. And so I actually became quite obsessed with learning everything I could about Facebook ads. And very recently, we actually launched a course for entrepreneurs who are on their way up. So for emerging entrepreneurs who are ready to start implementing Facebook ad campaigns for their business. And we took over 50 different Facebook ad courses. We sifted through all of the fluff and the overwhelming topics that they had. And we tried to come up with a way to give you guys all of the insider secrets on how to run profitable Facebook and Instagram ad campaigns without all of the extra overwhelming things that people add sometimes. Yes. And today we wanted to share with you a little part of our course, which is our worksheet. I can't speak today. I am so sorry, y'all. If you know me, you know that my English comes and goes sometimes. I'm Colombian, and so I have my days where I feel like, yes, my English is perfect. And then I have other days where I just completely forget how to speak altogether. Clearly, today is one of those days where I forgot. But as I was saying, I just wanted to share with you guys our really ultimate Facebook ad template. This is something that we share with our students in our Facebook ad course, but we thought it was too good not to share with you guys, since this is really something that you can start implementing right away.
Yes.
Okay, so without further ado, let's start going through the checklist. So we have notes, obviously, because we want to follow. So this is what the checklist looks like. Right here. And if you want to get a copy of this checklist so you know what we are talking about, you can go to chaseyourfears.com/learn. Okay, chaseyourfears.com/learn. And then you'll be able to download this little worksheet right here, which is going to help you with, you know, help you create amazing Facebook ads.
Yeah, so it's at the bottom of the page.
Yeah, so it's at the bottom of the page. If you scroll chaseyourfears.com/learn, you'll see at the bottom it says get your ultimate Facebook ad template checklist. Okay, so we're just gonna go through this right now and tell you guys how to create amazing Facebook ads. So the first thing that you wanna do when you are drafting an ad on Facebook is to start with a hook or a question.
Yeah.
And the reason why we want to start with a hook or a question is because usually people are scrolling through their feed and they're not scrolling because they're trying to purchase or buy anything. That's just not the reason why people go to Facebook. People go to Facebook because they're trying to be entertained, they're trying to network or interact either with peers in their business or with friends and family. So you need to be really aware of why people go to the platform so that you can write successful ads, right? So knowing that people go to Facebook not to buy things from you, you need to draft your ads with that understanding. So the first thing, again, we start with a hook or a question. Something that will get people to stop scrolling, right? You get them to stop scrolling, and also that hopefully will get them to say yes. So usually the most successful Facebook ads start with questions that the reader can respond yes to.
Yeah.
And the way that you do this is you really look back and you sit down and you think, who is my target audience? Who am I trying to speak to when I'm writing this ad? And you ask a question that would like push on a pain point, that would really like highlight a need or a problem that they have in their life, so that when you say, hey, are you struggling with da-da-da-da-da, people are like, yes, I can totally see myself in that message, and they'll be more keen to read what's coming next.
Yep, and if you've listened to us before, then we always say that you should fill out a customer avatar worksheet, and that actually goes through that, so it kind of helps you answer the question what clients are looking for, and that can be part of your headline.
Yeah. So once you have a very catchy question or a hook, part one, you then want to...
You want to build a connection with them. So after the headline part or the first sentence in your ad, you want to create more on another paragraph that connects with people.
Yeah. And how do you build that connection? Goes back to, I'm sorry, I'm going to tap here because the camera keeps on trying to focus into my face. So how do you build a connection with your target audience? Well, you, again, just like you did with the question, you focus on their desires and their needs, right? The things that they actually want, and how your product can help them with those desires.
Yeah.
Okay, so number three is to create a sense of urgency. And what I mean by creating a sense of urgency is using words like today. So sign up today, register for a webinar today, or words like flash sale or what else?
Limited time offer.
So you basically want to make it known to people that the ad that you are running and the offer that you are giving them is not going to be around forever. And the shorter the time frame is, the more success you'll have, because people have more of an incentive to purchase as soon as possible. You basically don't want people to look at your ad and say, oh, I'll come back to it later, because they never will. So you really want to get that sense of urgency right away.
Yes. Yep. And then the next one is that you have to create an irresistible offer. So something that your target audience would really want, and offer it to them.
So basically have a sexy offer, you know, like be sexy with your offer. Really think about, before you start running ad campaigns, I want you to really evaluate what it is that you are giving people in exchange for their email or for their profit. Like, does your product, does your lead magnet, the thing that you're offering people with your ads, does it actually solve a problem? Is it something that's desirable for your ideal client? Or is it just something that you thought about people may be interested in, but in reality, you're just kind of not really sure? Like, you didn't really do your research. Because honestly, you could spend a fortune on Facebook ads and get zero results. That's a very real possibility. If you really don't understand who you're speaking to, if you are not like verbalizing and using language that would connect to that person, but most of all, if your offer sucks. So if you have a shitty product, a shitty lead magnet, a shitty offer, no amount of ads is ever gonna fix that. So if your ideal client is not interested in what you're trying to sell to them, you are gonna have a really hard time with conversions. I hope that this is clear, because a lot of times people talk to Facebook ad strategists or marketing strategists and they're like, why didn't my Facebook ad campaigns work? And most of the time when you look at the ad itself, you realize, well, you didn't have a great offer. Like, I don't think your client was necessarily interested. So that is definitely critical. So far we have you, number one, you start with a hook. You build that connection on the next sentence. Number three, you create a sense of urgency. And this is all happening in the ad. So if you're asked, so this is what a Facebook ad will look like. This would be like a picture ad. And all of these things right here that we are discussing are things that you can actually include in the ad. So I know that you can't see that right now on Instagram, but we want you to go and download the worksheet. And then you'll actually be able to see where you need to be placing all of these different points that we're giving you to have the most success with your marketing.
Yeah, these are the ingredients for a successful ad.
Yes, the ingredients. So we're giving you the recipe for your ultimate ad, and the ingredients are all right here. You just gotta download it, and that way you can follow when you're doing your ad campaigns.
Yeah.
Okay, so create urgency. What is number four, Peter? Oh, you said have an irresistible offer.
Yes.
Have a sexy offer. You know, have something that people actually desire and want. And then you want to include a clear call to action. Now, this is really surprising to me, because sometimes I'm actually scrolling through Facebook and I see ads. And so many times I almost want to like screenshot the ad and send it to whoever's running it and saying, wait, you forgot the most important part. Like, I almost just want to start scamming people and being like, hey, you're doing this wrong. And so the most important part, sorry again, of an ad is actually the call to action. Because you could run an ad and you could put it in front of the right person and you could have an amazing offer.
Yep.
But if you're not telling people what you want them to do with the ad, your conversions are gonna suck. So if you have, for example, a PDF that you are offering for your prospects,
you could put download now.
Yeah, so if you have a PDF, you could put things like download now. Sorry guys, I'm just getting all kinds of messages, even though I have not the server. For a PDF, you could say things like download now. For a webinar, you could say something like
learn more
or register today.
Yeah.
But the point is, you gotta tell people what to do. And this is all across the board with your marketing. Be really clear about what you want people to do. And also only tell them to do one thing. So every piece of content that you're creating, like the content that really converts, it's content that only has one call to action.
Yeah, we see this so many times as a mistake. They'll tell people that you should sign up for my offer, learn more here, and then the button at the bottom of the ad will say, download now or something. So like three different ones or three different call to action.
And honestly, what happens? Like, I just want you to really put yourself in that position where you are, say you're at a conference, okay? Because you're really facing people and you kind of see the confusion. But say you're at a conference and then there's a speaker on stage and the speaker's like, hi guys, so excited you're here. Okay, what I want you to do now is I want you to take out your phone and start tweeting that you are here at a conference. But I also want you to pay attention right now because you can't miss what's coming up next. We're covering such amazing information. Oh, and I want you to get pumped up and start getting up and dancing because, you know, we want to get the energy flowing. You would be like, what the hell did you take? Like, you would be so confused and so overwhelmed, and it would just be like, you probably would sit in your chair frozen. Like, that's probably what would happen. Because realistically speaking, we can only focus on one task at a time. So as human beings, we are awful procrastinators. I know that all of us, especially all of us creatives, we love to think that we can do it all at once and have all the tabs open and pay attention to all of the things. But realistically, that is not true. We cannot multitask. The human brain is pretty awful at multitasking. So you need to be aware of that when you are doing marketing in any form, and it's just having one simple, clear call to action. That's it, nothing else. So if you want people to sign up for the webinar, the only thing you should be asking them to do on the ad is sign up for the webinar. You don't want them to be like, follow my page, comment below, tag a friend. No, none of that. Too much, too confusing, and it will kill your conversions.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, what's next, Pedro?
Next one is to use a shortened URL, like Bitly, for example, or another URL shortener. And the reason is that we've tested it. And for some people, like, we try to put pretty concise links where kind of the link describes what it is, what people are going to, but we've seen some people where it's like, it's their website and then like 10 different words as the link, and people are either going to get confused or you're already telling them exactly what's on that page.
Yes. So, you know, you don't want people to see, go to samswebsite.com/samlosthisdogs/ help me find it / whatever. No, you know, that's really a lot and people can see that and it just looks unprofessional. So just use a URL shortener so that people don't have to be subjected to like all of the things that happen, you know, when you have a long link.
Yes?
Okay, so after that, when you have a shortened URL, these are all the little extra things right here, which is like in your ad part, like in the bottom part of your ad that you see. You really gotta repeat again what the benefits are. So if you want people to get a PDF, you gotta say something like free download of a checklist for blah, 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 blah. So state what you're giving people for free, telling them the name of the offer, and then be as clear and concise as humanly possible.
And this is really important too, because it has to connect with the image. So if the top sentence didn't stop people yet in scrolling, then the image or this headline is what will catch their eye after that.
Yeah. Oh, right. We forgot about the image. I totally missed that. I am so sorry. I didn't see that. So you do. You got to have an image. Images are critical. An image or a video. If you're running ads, your image or video has to be like the rebel child that refuses to be like anybody else. You know, like moms, if you have kids or if you have pets, you know, the ones that are like rebellious and are like, I am not going with the flow. I'm doing the exact opposite. So that really works for Facebook and Instagram marketing. You want to be the rebel child. You want bold letters and loud colors and images that really catch your eye, because again, you are competing for people's fleeting attention. And you're trying to capture the attention of people that were not there in the first place to buy from you or learn about your product. And to do that, you can't just blend with the rest. You gotta like be unique, be bold, be weird, stand out. Also though, don't get too weird in the sense that you have like some random image that has nothing to do with your ad, because people would be able to tell that that's not authentic. But what I say by weird is just make sure that your imagery is bold enough and noticeable enough that it really catches the viewer's eye.
Yeah, bold, but still try to connect it to the message itself.
Yes, 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 yes. Okay, we have one more thing, and this one's my favorite. We call this one the extra credit part, because I know that there are certain businesses that are more serious, more corporate, and that this may not work as well for. But if you are in, you know, in like a more creative, I wouldn't even just say creative, but if you're in a business that is not too heavily regulated or too corporate or formal, another thing that you want to do in your ads that will increase your conversions by up to 20% is to include emojis. You know, the cute little emojis, like for me, I'm obsessed with dancing and sunshine and avocados. So I try to include those when I can, when it's relevant to the copy, obviously. But try to include, you know, 3 or 4 emojis in your ad. Don't go crazy. Don't use emojis every other word. That's annoying. But do get creative in the sense that those little images are actually going to draw the eye through the copy. As a person is reading your ad, they're going to be able to get drawn by the images. So the kind of having emojis in the text will kind of draw people through the text. For example, if you have a product that you're trying to promote and you want to highlight the benefits, instead of saying you can get a thing A, B, or C, and just writing the text, you could put a check mark right beside it for things that you would get.
Yeah, the emoji check mark.
And that emoji check mark will help you increase your conversions.
Yeah, or fill out a powerful statement and maybe put like, oh, you're gonna, or this will change your life, boom, and then you put like a little fire symbol next to it. So
yes. So just have fun with the emojis. I think that's one of the coolest parts of it. Okay, so that is really the power, the ultimate Facebook ad template. If you want this template, you want to have the checklist that you can basically, as you're writing your Facebook ads, or even as you're writing your marketing, because honestly, this is just a great guidebook for writing good copy, right? So if you need this checklist so that you can write better copy for your marketing, just go to our website, chaseyourfears.com/learn. And I think that's it. We really didn't have much else to cover today. We really just wanted to focus on ads. And the reason why we really wanted to focus on ads is because we get this all the time with small business owners that are just starting out, and they think that doing advertising, paid advertising, is only for the big businesses. And so with that mentality, the big businesses keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and they keep on having a wider reach, while the small, you know, emerging entrepreneurs are kind of falling behind. So we really wanted to cover Facebook ads today because we think, honestly, that Facebook and Instagram ads are so very powerful, especially for those of us who are emerging entrepreneurs. And we want you to be able to get the full benefit of these marketing strategies that the big companies are using, because everything I just shared with you right now, guys, this is what the big, large companies are doing to grow their audience, to expand their reach. And the thing is, you have this at your disposal. Facebook ads can be something that can adjust to your budget. You don't need to be rich to start running Facebook ads for your business. And so I really hope that this kind of got you curious.
Yeah.
a little bit about what it means to market your business on Facebook. And should you ever have any questions, if you're catching the replay and you're like, does my business work for Facebook ads? Would my business be a good match for Facebook advertising? Just send me a message and let me know. Also, if you want to know about our amazing course for emerging entrepreneurs who want to get the tactics that the big businesses are using to grow their brand, just send us a message right now. We have an incredible course. And for the first 100 people who sign up for the course, you can register for $127. Guys, yeah. Taking this course, what am I doing with my hair? Taking this course could save you so much money on wasted advertising, because we basically walk you through the entire process of creating a profitable ad campaign. We tell you how to target your ideal client. We tell you how to design ads that sell. We show you all of the insider secrets that you need to know so that you're not wasting a fortune. And we also help you set your budget and tell you how to get your messaging right so that you are appealing to your dream audience. So if this sounds like something that could work for you, do not hesitate to DM me, no pressure at all. I love having conversations with all of you guys. All right, you beautiful people, thank you for tuning in. We had such a great time. Just remember, we do these cafecito times every single week. So every Tuesday, 12:30 p.m. Eastern, 6:30 p.m. CEST time. That is
Central European time,
which is where we're at. Okay. Love you all. See you next week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.